Welcome to class once again. This is
Class five.
The Gospel of Matthew, and I think we rushed through.
Finish of four. We got it.
Last time, so we're starting right with lesson five.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Father, we thank you once again. Yes. Thank you for these students. Thank you for the ready hearts, the ready minds. And I pray that you will saturate us, Lord. Just saturate us with your presence,
Father.
With your power, your anointing. May the word of the Lord just come alive within us. We pray for the spirit of revelation. We pray in Jesus' name that you will minister to us, Lord, at the level that we can understand, that it can become a workable part of us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Gospel of Matthew, lesson five. I think, we're starting in the eighth chapter of Matthew. Mm-hmm. Now, this is the fifth week. Matthew has 28 chapters. Something tells me we're not going to be able to go into much detail in a lot of the chapters that we have been so far. The book of Matthew is just such a rich book. In fact, Mr. Barclay, he got about 700 pages of commentary on it. Let's read the first three verses. When he had come down from the mountain, now what was the occasion when he came down from the mountain?
He was doing the Sermon on the Mount.
Yeah. Okay. Sermon on the Mount, chapters 5, 6, and 7. And that was to whom? Sermon on the Mount was it to just anybody? Everybody?
It was to his inner circle more than anyone.
It's mainly the teaching and instruction
to
of
his
disciples.
Disciple.
When he had come down from the mountain, great multitudes followed him. And behold, a leper came and worshipped him, saying, Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean. And Jesus put out his hand and touched him, saying, I am willing, be cleansed. Immediately his leprosy was cleansed. Now, several very inspiring things here. Number one is the leper was considered to be just totally isolated. Mm-hmm. I mean, he was not even supposed to be around other people, and no one was supposed to touch him. But Jesus put out his hand and touched him. I would imagine that Jesus would not have had any problems reaching out, touching people with AIDS.
No.
Of course, I guess it was a myth that you just touch somebody with AIDS, you get AIDS, but that's not true.
No.
Now, if you touch somebody with leprosy, you might get leprosy. But here's something that's very interesting, is that he came and worshiped him. Isn't that what the emphasis has been here? That we worship.
Yes.
And then we receive
miracles.
If thou will, if you're willing, you can make me clean. And I like to think of it this way. When people ask if healing is God's will, or Lord, heal me if it be your will, I think I can unequivocally say that it's God's will to heal.
It is his will.
It's God's will to heal. I don't understand. I don't understand why sometimes he doesn't, sometimes he doesn't. We can always say, well, you know, it's lack of faith or whatever. And if the Bible says, ask what you will and it shall be done, and if you ask and it's not done, then there's something missing there, isn't it? Ask and it shall be given you. You ask. Of course, James.
You ask and receive not because you ask amiss that you may consume it upon your lust.
Well, let's see. First of all, it said you receive not because you ask not. Right?
Yeah, I believe
and
that.
Then, and then
later
you,
he said,
then
you
ask
and
amiss.
Receive not because you ask amiss.
Mm-hmm.
Now, it could be, and I have seen this, that sometimes people will ask for something that would seem on face value to be good, but they're asking for the wrong reasons. And that might be why some things aren't received.
Mm-hmm. Well, and just I think that, and this is just another thought also. I believe God will hear you anytime you cry out to him, anytime that you cry out for salvation. His ear is not heavy, they cannot hear you. And as many shall call upon the name of the Lord, they shall be saved. But I also believe that there are times that God will heal us in spite of our abusing ourselves. And that just be through his pure mercy.
His goodness, right.
But then exactly. You continuously abuse yourself in the same manner. I don't know. It seems to me that at some point in time that, like Jesus said, you're not going to sin no more unless a worse thing come upon you.
Maybe some of it's just a worse thing that's come upon you.
I think sometimes he leaves you with something because somewhere along the way it's going to help you with another individual.
Well, that's true. And I think where that would fit in is that all things work together for the good of those that love the Lord and call according to his purpose, which means that regardless of the situation, regardless of how bad something is, they can all turn around and be used for good. It does not necessarily mean that God orchestrated it,